Welcome to Airgun TV.
Hello there, welcome to the Airgun Gear Show Christmas Special. Now, something that really annoys us here on the Airgun Gear Show is Christmas adverts. They're everywhere. Come and buy your bra from here. Come and buy your nice perfume from here. Or come to this shop and buy your kids' toys. But at no point do you ever see an advert that pops up on the television that says, "Ooh, lovely new air rifle, come and buy one." Because that's not politically correct. So what we thought we'd do on this Christmas special is we'd show you exactly what some of the main players in the industry have got for sale for Christmas. It's not possible to get all the gun manufacturers to come to us. So we're going to go to them. And that means a road trip. Whee! You don't want to watch me driving up and down the motorway doing things in this vehicle. We're not Top Gear, you know. So in the meantime, here's some outtakes for you to have a look at.
And add a shooting glove with a non-stick palms, well, it's like glue.
Outtake.
But as an Airwolf, but as a Daystate Airwolf owner myself for a number of years, here's a tip. Always put your on-off key on your car keys, because I guarantee one day you will go.
Well, here we are then. 3 hour drive up the M5 and the M6. But where is he, I hear you wondering? I've been given special permission to have a wander around the inside workings of Daystate. As soon as you walk in, you get a feel for the Daystate pedigree, starting with the old rifles from many years ago, through to their collection of new rifles, which are all available today. Walking through the workshops is a strange experience because you keep seeing bits of guns lying around and all the bits look a bit familiar. Testing is comprehensive. These air cylinders will sit for sometimes weeks on end to make sure that there are no leaks. All the parts are laid out beforehand and then tested thoroughly before any of them meets a stock. The trigger assembly is an art form which can sometimes take hours for every rifle. But this is probably one of the most important men in the building. This is Malcolm, and he's quality control, and everything gets checked by him before it goes out of the building. So some lucky owner has just got themselves a new Huntsman. This is going to be a lovely Christmas present for someone. Now, for those of you that have bought a Daystate, you will see the checklist just inside the box. And this is done by Malcolm. And Malcolm is the person that puts the squiggle on the box, signs the check sheet to say everything is okay. And this rifle can then go out to what is going to be a very happy new owner. Thank you. one Daystate ready to go. Now another very important person in the building is Angie. Now if you've ever had a problem with a Daystate, or you've sent one back for a service, or you've needed something delivering, Angie is probably the person you've spoken to. And as you can see, she's very busy. Now this is Angie's Christmas tree. Angie's very proud of her Christmas tree, and no one is to say a word against it. In the stock room, we find Santa Twig and Tony running through the Christmas orders.
Bruce from Sydney, and he wants an Airwolf. Right, now it's Chip from Wisconsin, and he wants a Huntsman. Okay, Pierre from Paris, Airwolf Tactical. And Manuel from Madrid wants an Air Ranger. Are you all right there? Giorgio from Milan wants a Wolverine. Oh, we haven't got many of those. And finally, we've got Nigel from Preston, who wants a Panther. Let's get that lot on the sleigh.
In the dark depths of the workshops, here we find the elves working hard to build your Christmas presents. On every workbench, there's a nice surprise. Here we can see some special edition stocks that are being prepared. Here I am then, with the man who's in charge of all this, Tony Bilas. Tony, thank you ever so much for having us to Daystate today.
My pleasure, thank you for coming.
As it's Christmas, which we all know, I thought you might like to take a couple of minutes and just show everyone your range of rifles and what they might like to treat themselves to at Christmas time.
I'll be pleased to. Let's have a look. Well, Daystate has essentially four rifles, two mechanical and two electronic, and they split down quite nicely into Air Ranger and Air Wolf, Huntsman and Mark IV. So I want to go through and show you the different ones that we've got here. We keep a display room like this for people who turn up, just want to have a look at some guns. We don't sell from here, you have to go to a shop to buy them, but at least you've got something to see if you visit the factory. So I have an Air Ranger, which is mechanical, and an Air Wolf, and you can see they look pretty much the same, except that one has an electronic heart. Daystate's patented MCT electronic hearts in there, and this has a mechanical heart. And what we say is, if you're a hunter, absolute hunter, using an air rifle, then perhaps the mechanical systems for you, nice and simple, easy to use. But if you're an enthusiast, an air gun shooter, I happen to be hunting, then the electronics would be the way to go. More fun of the fair, more to do, more to see, more to play with, but actually very refined and give a lot of shots. So that's the Air Wolf, and this is the Air Ranger. Moving along, we have our renowned Mark IV rifle, replaced the Mark III about 3 years ago, and has been refined since then. Essentially designed as a target rifle for hunter field target, but also useful in the field. We do three versions of this. We do a standard version, we do a thumb hole version, and we do a target version, a target stock. They're all good enough to go target shooting, but this year we did a target rifle version as well. The Mark IV comes with its IS display screen, which allows you to see what's going on inside the rifle. It also features a 10-shot magazine and can be fitted by the user with a magnetically attached single-shot tray. So you've got something to go target shooting with and can also take hunting. You can see on this one, I've got a silencer screwed on. On this one, we've taken it off so you can see the difference. Moving along, have the Airwolf Tactical. This is another electronic rifle, similar electronics to the Mark IV, but this time it's based on the Airwolf, and it's all blacked out to give it this mean black finish. Rubberized textured stock here.
which gives it a non-slip coating, and we've also shortened down the air shroud to make it more pointable. That's the Airwolf Tactical. Below that, we have the Huntsman. We featured the Huntsman on a previous show, and it's a very small, very light rifle that we do, the smallest rifle in the Daystate range. Small shot capacity because of the air cylinder, but still does 80 shots per charge in 12-foot pounds. That's quite an achievement. This rifle can be tuned up for overseas markets and will do an incredible 45-foot pounds in one version. So a very nice rifle from the Daystate, one of our most popular rifles. I mentioned the target stock version of the Mark IV, and here it is, the Mark IV Panther, Mark IV Target. And you've got a rubberized finish being used yet again on this rifle to give it a functional use. It has adjustable everything, adjustable butt pad, adjustable cheek piece, up, down, left, right, and also an optional four-end handrail, which is adjustable up and down, forward and backwards, to give you a bit more depth onto your knee or standing. It helps you brace it. You can see in this case we fitted the single shot tray, but it also comes with a magazine if you want to take it hunting. The rifle has got a muzzle compensator on the end here called a still air, which is adjustable by the user to reduce the amount of flip or increase the amount of flip if you want a bit more liveness in one of these rifles. And you can fit a silencer over that to silence it all down. This rifle is interesting because it has one of the latest scopes on it. It's an MTC Genesis, brand new for 2012. Just coming into stock now, here we are in December of 2011, and it's a 5 to 20 magnification, quite a useful zoom on that. Quite a small scope, which is also quite nice. 50mm objective lens, incredibly bright glass. It has side parallax, which is from 10 yards to infinity, and also illuminated multi-lined reticle. So you've got hundreds of aiming points, and you can illuminate the center of the reticle for when the light starts to go. So very nice scope. Watch out for that in 2012.
I'm sure you'll agree, Daystate have got a fantastic range of rifles, something to suit every price and budget. Tony, thank you ever so much for having us here again today.
My pleasure.
Absolutely.
Thanks for coming.
Brilliant. Now, guys, you need to remember that I've been very privileged to be allowed in behind the scenes at Daystate, but the factory is not open to the public. If you'd like to look at the Daystate range of rifles, please contact your local gun shop. There is details of registered dealers that are on the Daystate website, and they'll be more than happy to help you. Okay, everyone done? Right. Okay.
Wait a minute, Giles. Santa Twig's had a word with me and he wants us to help with deliveries.
Oh.
Here's your hat. Here's your tinsel toes. Let's get on with it.
Okay.
Ho, ho, ho.
Ho, ho, ho. Well, I've had a great time here at Daystate and I've seen Santa Twig, but I haven't been able to tell him what I want for Christmas. Anyway, I'm going back down the M6 now to show you something else, but in the meantime, while I'm doing the drive, here's another outtake.
Action. Here we go.
Action. It's okay. Someone's going to get the first aid kit.
He never even tried to shoot the pigeon.
Cut. Do it again.
Right, do yours a bit louder.
Hang on, okay, it's okay.
He's the one, I'm the one covered in badger shit.
Get on with it.
Oh, are you going? You're going to keep making me laugh.
Running.
You keep making.
Is it?
Hang on, okay.
10 seconds left, action.
It's okay, someone's going to get the first aid kit.
He never even tried to shoot the pigeon.
Okay, so stop number two on our road trip. The road sign might give it away, but if that doesn't, the big sign outside the building will. Now, we've very kindly been allowed to take a tour behind the closed doors of BSA. And as you can tell, there's history oozing everywhere. Now, the moment you walk onto the factory floor, you're struck by the old and the new. And we'll have a look at the old first. BSA, which has a fine history of gun making, still relies on some of the older techniques. And there's some very specialised kit here, all being looked after by people that have done this for years. Now, one of the older techniques I'm talking about is making your own barrels. BSA make their own barrels. They're not brought in or shipped in. They actually do the whole process here. And this will end up being a barrel on a rifle in the future. Tucked away in every part, there's machinery. Some of it is quite secretive, and I'm not allowed to show you exactly what it does or how it does it. All I can tell you is that that machine over there puts holes in things and rifling. Now, one of the things that's very pleasing to someone who's a little bit old-fashioned like me is that we still have the trades doing it the old-fashioned way. Over there are all the dips, where everything gets treated and the bluing process takes place. However, as you do walk around, every now and again you spot a modern bit of kit. This is a CNC machine, if I've said that correctly. It is fully computer controlled. It has all the drill bits and the mechanisms in it, and that is also part of the barrel making process. All the metal is worked in one section of the factory, and when it's been prepared and blued and brought to the exact standards that BSA want, it's taken through into the production area to be made into rifles. This is the R10 work area, and all the parts are lined up, ready to be put together. Walking around BSA makes you realise just what a huge operation it is. There's all sorts of rifles being made in all sorts of places, and I'm not even halfway round. As you can see, every rifle is tested. The pellet goes into the barrel, it's fired, and the readout is checked. And the readout says exactly where the pellet has hit and how fast it's travelling. And this goes on and on for each rifle. Dotted around everywhere, you find items on rest, and they're on pressure test. This is a very important part of the BSA process. It is the aftercare to the customer. So if you've ever had an issue, or you require a service or a warranty repair, it's going to come back to this area. Two of the most important people in the company are Andrew and Richard, because they are the people that you might talk to if you ever have a question about your gun. Any queries or testing you need doing on your gun, these are the people that are going to look after you. As it's Christmas, there's one character that I'm looking out for, and I haven't seen him yet, and I'm getting a little bit worried that he's not... There he is. Santa Twig! Santa Twig! Stop! Stop! Oi! I catch up with Santa Twig, but I can't talk to him because he's actually doing a Christmas prize draw with Martin Lowe, the MD of BSA.
So Santa, we're having a prize draw. Would you please draw one of the names out of this hat? And the winner is... Mark Anderson. So Mark, many congratulations on winning the draw. Here is your own personalised R10 with the compliments not just of Santa, but of all of BSA. Many Thank congratulations. Much. Happy Christmas.
Thank you very much. Ho, ho, ho.
Well, that was a surprise. But I still haven't got to talk to Santa Twig. I'll catch up with him somewhere else, I hope. But in the meantime, let's have a look at BSA's range of guns. Now, Mark was lucky enough, he's won the R10. Very, very nice. Then, of course, they've got things like the Scorpion SE, the Sporter, and the Ultra Shot. They're all PCPs, great for anything from target practice, hunter field target, better hunting, everything you need. Now, you mustn't forget that BSA also do Springer rifles, such as the Comet, the Meteor, the Super Sport, the Hornet. There's plenty to choose from. And of course, BSA's parent company, Gammo, are a massive manufacturer in Europe. So don't forget their kit, because that's pretty good too. Here we are then. This is the man that looks after everyone. This is Martin Lowe. He's the MD of BSA. Martin, thank you ever so much for letting us in today and have a walk round. It's been very good of you.
It's a great pleasure. Thank you for taking the time and trouble to come and see us.
Thank you. Now, Martin, would you like to tell everyone how can they look at your products? Where can they perhaps meet you, see you and your team? How can they do that?
Be very happy to do so. Well, the first thing to say is that our products are available from all good gun retailers across the UK. We also have a network of international distributors in most of the markets across the world, in Europe and in North America in particular. And thirdly, we are exhibiting at a number of exhibitions both in this country and abroad in the next few months. For example, we will be at SHOT Show in Las Vegas in January. We will be at the British Shooting Show in February in Nottinghamshire. And we will be at IWA in March in Germany. We look forward to welcoming all customers, both existing and prospective, to any of those shows.
Fantastic. So, anything exciting happening next year? Any new products from BSA?
Of course, we've always thrived on developing lots and lots of new products. And although I can't tell you any secrets at this point, we are going to be unveiling at the IWA show in March in Germany some exciting new products.
Wow.
Build on our heritage, but continue our development of new technology brought into air guns for the benefit of shooters.
Fantastic. We should look forward to that.
Great.
Lovely.
Thank you.
Martin, thank you ever so much for your time today.
Thank
you, team, as well. And wish you a Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
If everyone could remember that BSA is a closed factory, it doesn't do tours, it's not open to the public, and that's one of the reasons why walking around like this is so special. However, I've got to go now, but I am going somewhere else. So, while I'm doing some driving, here's some more outtakes. Thank you, mate. Nice fun, fella. One of the unsung heroes, aren't you? Mate, you've got to do it quick and Nige.
Yeah.
You've got to whip them like about 15.
Just put it in your scope. Put it, don't worry about aiming onto it.
No, it's too late. Dangle it in front of the barrel, Merv. No, it's not soon enough, though. You need... How many did he hit there, mate?
Zero.
Memory's playing up. I can't recollect about any hits at all.
It's not like that.
So the last place on my Christmas tour is Brocock. Here we are then, I'm with Nigel from Brocock. We're in the gun room or the display room, looks very good. Now, Nigel's gonna tell us a few things that Brocock have got to offer for Christmas.
Thank you. Hi everybody, welcome to Brocock. My name is Nigel Silcock. I'm the owner of Brocock in Redditch. Come to show you a couple of new things that we've got on the drawing board today. This is the Atomic, a multi-shot pistol that we've just been developing over the last couple of months. We broke into the pre-charge market about 12 months ago. It took off like a storm. Biggest biggest thing for us about our pre-charge is it's the lightweight. It's available for young people to use, for youngsters, for disabled people. That was our main process of bringing in this range of products. That's the Atomic that we're producing at the moment. We've now developed a stainless steel mag, which gives it a lot more accuracy. It's a lot more robust, but the biggest improvement we've made on it, the original ones we made, we had the action on the right-hand side. Right-hand side was very, very slow to load. Ideal for left-handers, but if you're a right-hander, you can see, as I'm loading it, I'm cocking it back, pushing it forward, then I'm pointing at my target, then I'm changing hands, doing the same again. The new ones that we're just bringing out are slow, slightly different, where we've got the action on the opposite side, so it really makes firing very, very quickly, as I can demonstrate. So this would be probably the fastest loading PCP on the market today. We then developed a range of rifles, which again are a lightweight rifle. All of them are six pellets. Very easy to load. I'll just show you how you load the guns. You pull the bolt back. You take the little magazine out, as you can see. You load six pellets into the magazine. And there you go, it's ready for firing.
This is Paul. Paul builds, pretty much all of the rifles here. So what sort of process do you have to go through, Paul? What are you doing today?
We're actually fitting the bar and breech block assembly to the main pressure tube.
Mm-hmm.
The main pressure tube obviously being filled with compressed air. Bar and breech block assembly has to be fitted nice and true, so everything's nice and true, so it shoots accurately.
Yeah.
Inside right. The pressure tube there's a series of valves. An inlet valve which goes on the end that you actually fill it, and an exhaust valve which meters the pressure that goes into the barrel for your consistency and your power.
Lovely. Right. How many of these do you think you do a day?
Around about 10.
Wow. That keeps you busy then.
It does, yeah.
Is there anything I can do to help?
Yeah, of course you can. You can put a few of those valves together if you wish.
You trust me?
I would think so, yeah.
Right. Now, if you're going to buy a Brocock rifle, I may have built a bit on it. So if it goes wrong, send it back to Paul. There we go. There's four, is that enough?
Yeah, that'll do.
Lovely. We'll go and see what John's doing. So this is John. You got a smile. Now, John is lubing the tubes. What he's actually doing is putting lube on the pressure valves, which are going to go into the pressure reservoirs. Right, I'm going to leave. Don't laugh. Outtakes. In fact, after all my dashing around, I've been to Daystate, BSA, and now I'm here in Brocock. I think I deserve a coffee. But there's one person I really want to talk to, and that's Santa Twig. I'm going to drink this, see if I can find him. Got him. This time he's not getting away. Right. I think he looks a little busy.
Oh, Santa Twig, that's not a way to order your presents.
I'll come back a bit later. I think I'm a little bit shocked. By what I've just seen, maybe even a little bit disturbed. Now, we've been told to stop filming because John's got a joke. Go on then.
What's Bruce Lee getting for Christmas?
Don't know.
A toy!
And on that note, I think it's time for me to go home. I need to thank everyone here at Brocock for getting involved. Sarah, Nigel, the team upstairs, absolutely brilliant. We've had a scream. There we are. I'll see you back at the farm. I've spent the last few days trying to get to talk to Santa Twig and tell him what I want for Christmas. And I think I found the entrance to his grotto. Let's go in and have a chat.
Oh, look everyone, I finally caught up with Santa Twig. Hello Santa Twig, how are you? Okay, right. I've been looking for you everywhere. I've followed you around all the gun places. I've been trying to get hold of you and it... Okay, you're busy. I can see you're busy. Right, okay, okay, fine. Well, look, I really want to talk to you about... Right, well, for Christmas, what I'd like would be a dream air rifle. I'd like something that comes built with a silencer and a scope. Let's make it really, really nice. You know, let's have a really, really good one. So, well, I know it's a bit pushy. I'm well aware of that. I don't just want a tin of pellets. Look, please, if you can do something for me, that would be great. Okay, thank you very much. That's very good of you. Now, the thing is, I'm aware that, and I think we're all aware, that you run around and do an awful lot for everyone. I mean, is there anything we could do for you for Christmas, Santa Twig wants? What does Santa Twig? Oh dear. Right, okay, I can't arrange that, can I? I mean, that's just not possible. Okay, it's gonna be like that, is it? Well, thank you very much. Nice to meet you. Goodbye. It's Christmas Eve. And I'm waiting for Santa Twig to arrive, and hopefully he's going to bring me a nice present. I've got to go to bed though, I know that, but I've left him out a plate of lead pellets and a glass of gun oil in case he gets thirsty on the way around. But I guess it's just off the bed with me. Go to sleep and wake up in the morning and see what's under the tree. Well, I'm in bed and I'm quite excited. No, stop. Don't lower the tone. All right, okay, just go with this, will you? It's a Christmas special. I'm in bed, and I don't know what Santa Twig's gonna bring me. I can't wait, but I really must try and get some sleep. Good night. Santa Twig's bean. Look at that. Let's see what it is. Oh my word. It's a Daystate Airwolf. With a new Genesis 5x20x50 scope and a silencer. How pleased am I? Thank you, Santa Twig. I have to tell you, I am so happy with my Christmas present, and I think I'll probably do a review of it in the new year, and we might use it for some special projects that we've got in mind. But in the meantime, thank you to everyone that's got involved with us over the last 12 months. It has been a privilege working with everyone in the industry. Nigel Allen, thank you ever so much. The time and the effort and the patience that you've shown in helping us put this program together, it's been brilliant. So, all that I need to do now is wish you a very happy Christmas and a very happy new year, and we will see you in the new year. Bye-bye.